Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. It's been a while, it's been a long time since I last made a video. So without wasting much time, I don't want this video to be very long. Today I want to talk about, I want to share with you a story. And the story is about the dramatic birth of my son. Actually, the topic of this video is my dramatic childbirth. I almost lost my life giving birth to this child, to my last born, my last son, Heaven. Yeah, so guys, this video could be so long, could be long. That's why I'm going to make it in, I might end up making this video in two parts in case it becomes so long. So just make sure you watch to the end. And in case I make the second part, that you watch the second part, or else you will not be able to connect to what I am talking about. Yeah, I was 39 weeks pregnant, heavily pregnant. I was already tired of carrying this pregnancy around. I just wanted to carry my baby. You know, guys who have been pregnant before, at 39, from 38 weeks going 39, you already become so impatient, and you just want, you cannot wait to carry your child. You cannot wait to deliver this baby. So from the 39 weeks, I was looking, really looking forward to the end of this pregnancy, looking forward to carrying my son. I tried everything on YouTube that they suggested. I danced, I ate pineapples, I did I don't know which exercises. I did all kind of things just to help my body or help the baby or whatever. I was just trying to help myself to come into labor. I really didn't want to go up to 40 weeks or 41 weeks. I never imagined how someone can be pregnant for 41 weeks, because with my first pregnancy, I gave birth to my child, my first child, at 38 weeks. Yeah, and my second son was through cesarean at 38 weeks. So this third pregnancy, I really didn't want it to go that far, you know. So one is really tired, you just want to give birth. You all understand what I mean. So at 39 weeks, I tried everything, nothing is happening. At 40 weeks came and ended, nothing is happening. So at a point, I stopped practicing, doing all those things. I just said, let me just wait. So then we logged in 41 weeks. Then I had my last checkup at 41 weeks, my last scanning. Went to the doctor, and he tried to help me by applying on my cervix. He applied something on my cervix. It's called clove oil. You know cloves, guys. There's an oil called clove oil. In German, it's called Nelkenöl. So that clove oil, if you apply it on your cervix, guys, you'll get into labor pain, believe me. So he applied the thing on my cervix and told me to rush home, that in maybe in 2 or 3 hours I'll get my labor pains. So I was not in a hurry. I went to the supermarket, did some shopping. Yeah, bought what I wanted, then I went home. On reaching home, I was so tired, I went to sleep. But I could not even sleep deep. I started to experience pains, like period pains from far. Yeah, so I knew, yeah, my labor pains are starting. Yeah, but before, weeks before, I used to have all this, whatever they're called, this not really labor pains, you know, just pains that you think they're labor pain, then they disappear again. So they were just like that. So I didn't take the pain so seriously. So after some time, my husband was home, thanks God, that day he was free. So it didn't take long. The pains became intensive. I could not even eat dinner. And the pains were just becoming more and more intensive. So I told my husband, you know what? I think this is it. This is it. Just you guys eat whatever you're eating. Me, I didn't want to eat. I just waited for them to eat. Then I told my husband, finish eating. When you finish, then we have to go to the hospital. I think this is it. These are the real pains. So when they finished eating, then I packed my bag before, 2 weeks before. So my husband drove me to the hospital. I already organized with my sister to come and pick up my children in case I don't come back home. So then we went to the hospital. And on the way to the hospital, these pains were becoming more and more and more intensive. They were really, really intensive. They were so intensive, guys. I thought my water was going to break on the road. Yeah. So, just as you can have it. On reaching the hospital, the moment I saw the hospital building, the labor pains disappeared. That's the moment you just feel like cursing everything. Yeah, because without this intensive labor pains, they will not admit me. They'll just send me home. So, seeing the hospital building, the labor pains disappear. Yeah, we went to the maternity wing. They let us in. I explained to them that I have labor pains. Yeah. Though at that moment they had gone, but I just had to learn that they're very intensive. So we went. Then they started to examine me. The nurse started to examine me. Yeah. And yeah, they are not stupid. Of course, they will see how intensive your labor pains are, or whether you have labor pains or not. But they can't tell you. They don't want to embarrass you. So, so the nurse checked me, and I was not even half a centimeter open. My cervix was not even ripe. Yeah. It was not even half a centimeter open. Then the nurse, the midwife, sent my husband, told my husband, you know what? You do this. I don't think this woman is going to give birth tonight or even tomorrow, but I don't want to send her home. So you do this. You just go back home. We are going to admit her here, monitor her through the night. And then we see what will happen further. Maybe if she'll get labor pains, or maybe we'll end up injecting her, whatever. So my husband was sent home, and I was left there alone. But it didn't take long. The moment my husband went, like 30 minutes later, I just felt a very sharp pain, and I just remember I screamed very loud. A very sharp pain. My water broke, guys. So when I shouted, the nurse came, and the moment she heard me, my scream, she already knew these people, their experience. So the midwife, she heard my scream, and then she just came and told me, yeah, your water has broke. I told her, yeah, my water has broken. I was wet all over. My bed was full of water. Yeah. So it didn't take long. The moment my water broke, the labor pains started, like, intensively, without any break. And it was becoming serious, becoming more and more and more and more. Yeah. So I called my husband to come back. He had reached home. My sister was also there already. She already came to pick my children. So my husband was home already. I told him, yeah, just come back. Because the pains are here. There's no going back. We have to get this baby tonight. Or latest tomorrow morning. So he drove back to the hospital. They didn't waste time. And the pains were becoming more and more and more intensive. It was becoming more and more intensive. I don't remember the last time I had such terrible pains. Even with the birth of my first child, I never had such terrible pains. Never. It was becoming more intensive and more intensive and more intensive. What kind of pain is this? I was wondering. This pain is too much. So I was transferred to the real labor room, yeah, where there are all equipment and all whatever, whether you want to hold yourself on the rope or you want to jump on the ball or you want to jump in the sink, whatever you want to do, everything. That room was full of anything you can imagine of, yeah. Oh. When they took me to this room, the pains were just unbearable. So the midwife came and asked me, do you want PDA? A PDA is epidural. Yeah, this is the pain relief. And I bravely said, no, I don't want epidural. I want to go through the normal labor pain, like an Hebrew woman. Yeah. I want to experience the labor pain like an African woman. I told her, I don't want. I went through the labor pain, continued having pain. The pains were becoming too intensive. At a point, I rang the bell and I told the nurse to bring me something, some painkillers, Panadol or ibuprofen or anything. So she brought me something. I can't remember what it was, but there were just some tablets. But was it Buscopan or something? Yeah, I think it was Buscopan. But it was not helping me. It wasn't helping me at all. The pains were becoming unbearable. So by the time my husband came back, my condition was so serious, guys. I could not even stand. When the pains came, I could not stand. I could not sit. I could not lie down. I don't know. I just felt like I just rolled on the floor. They just come and pain me for like 5 minutes and go back again. Just so by the time he came, the pains were so serious. Yeah, it didn't last long. When he came back, it didn't last long. I was now vomiting. I started to vomit. I vomited the first time. When the pain comes, now it comes with vomit. The moment it starts, I start experiencing the pain. At the same time, I will vomit. I will vomit. I vomited everything out of my body. I almost vomited my intestines. So I vomited once, twice, thrice. And the pains were unbearable. I could not even lie down. I told my husband, help me to, help me to lie down. When I want to lie down, I can't even lie down. The pain is just too much. It was just too much. I never experienced this kind of pain before in my life. Never. It was not like that with my first child. Oh, it is at this point, guys, I gave up. I said, you know what? To hell with the Hebrew woman. I am not going to get an Oscar. I am not going to be given an Oscar for having labor pain for 12 hours or for 20 hours or for 22 hours. Nobody's going to give me an Oscar. There is an option of me going through this process with zero pains, and I have chosen to go through this torture. You know what I told my husband? No, at this point, I can't anymore, because I'm already becoming very weak. The night is still long, and I have not even opened, my cervix has not even opened half a centimeter. The pains are unbearable. I am already vomiting. I'm becoming so weak. I don't think I can make it until morning. I don't think I can go through this until the baby comes. So you know what we're going to do? I am going to take this PDA. I'm going to ask for this wonder, magical pain relief that white women take, yeah? To hell with an African woman. I am going to do this thing. So my husband also was having the same we agreed, even if he didn't agree, it is my body, I'm the one going through the pain, not him. So it was just he said it's okay if that's what you want. Then he called the midwife. And then they called the doctor, and I sent some papers that is what I want. And I had an epidural labor pain or epidural birth. They injected me the epidural. Yeah. So for people who don't know what is PDA, epidural, it is a form of anesthesia. It is a pain relief. They inject it at your on the spinal cord at your lower back, and it numbs the whole of your the lower parts of your body, from your waist or from where they inject it going down up to your legs. The whole lower part of your body will be numb, in that you don't feel anything. Even if someone cuts you with a knife, you will not feel anything. Okay. So after some time, when they injected me this thing, after some time, it was effective, in that when the labor pains came, I could not feel anything. I didn't feel anything. In short, is to say, I went through the labor pain without feeling anything from the moment I got the PDA, the epidural. Yeah. So after some time, and my husband, thanks God, my husband was given a place to sleep in the same room with me. So when they injected me this thing, and I had some relief, I was not experiencing any pains anymore. So I tried to sleep so that I have energy later. When the time for pushing out the baby comes, then I have energy and I'm strong enough. So we slept, but you know, you cannot sleep deep, but at least it was enough just for resting. Yeah. So after some time, the midwife came and checked me again, and thanks God, this time I was already 4 centimeters, my cervix was already 4 centimeters open. That was a really, I was really progressing very fast, and without feeling any pain, with the pains on the background, 4 centimeters open. I will not have done that on my own without any pain relief. So around 4 o'clock in the morning, no, around 6 o'clock in the morning, the midwife checked me again, and this time I was 9 centimeters open. Yeah, then I knew, now we're not so far. After some time now, maybe in 2 hours or so, I will be holding my baby. Yeah, so I remember even writing my sister an SMS and telling her, oh God, thanks God, I'm 9 centimeters open. Very soon now, we'll be over this. We'll be over with this childbirth business. So, it didn't take long. I was 10 centimeters open. Oh, that is the joy of everybody who is going through labor pain, to just hear that you are 10 centimeters open, because that one is just like to say you're almost there. Yeah. So I was 10 centimeters open. And normally when you have the PDA, when you have finally reached your maximum, 10 centimeters is the maximum you can open. That means the child is now almost coming out. Then then they remove it. They switch it off, and now they allow you to go through the normal labor pain. Because without the normal labor pain, you will not be able to push out the baby. You understand? So at this point now, they switched off the PDA, and I had to go through the normal labor pain. So with the normal labor pain and the added extra oxytocin is the hormone that makes the uterus to contract. You understand? It is that normally the body produces it on its own, but in my case, I had the normal labor pain, and they added the artificial one also, so that it was more effective. So as to help push up the baby. So the last part of my labor pain, without oxytocin, without a PDR. It didn't last long anyway. It was a very short process. It was a very short process. I don't remember. Pushing the baby for so long. After some time, you know, after a short time, my baby came out. My baby was born. Yeah. So, and then the drama started from there. I think this video is already becoming so long. The next part, I am going to narrate what happened after the childbirth. And now that is where the drama began. Okay? So stay tuned for part 2.